this video, I'm going to go over transmog. Looking at the new mail armor. Yeah, that looks about right. Yeah, I'm guessing it's all the first one. So, pretty much this is the one of the new mail sets. I don't know if this will be for Hunter and Shaman or if it's just for Hunter. But I did get to see something that was interesting. So, let's see. Let's take a look at weapons. One-handed axes. That's not an axe. That's a mace. It's more of a club. This comes from a raid. Ooh, people are gonna have fun with that one. That must be a placeholder. I really like that model, actually. That's really good. This is... okay, some things must definitely not be labeled correctly, because that's not an axe. That's like a wand or something. They're definitely going for like an Aztec feel. Oh, that is a sweet axe. Oh no, that's not an axe, that's a gun. It's got a little... it's got the trigger there, and it's got the barrel there. That is a really big bayonet, then. I have to wonder if that'll be considered a gun, or if it's actually an axe. Because it looks more like an axe, but there's a gun on it. And that looks like everything in the axes category, so let's go with swords. Oh, that looks nice. Oh, definitely. I prefer this coloration over this one. That is very interesting looking. This is a one-handed sword. I would definitely dual wield that for some kind of transmog if I could make one. That's a pretty boring sword. How is that one-handed? That looks like a two-handed sword. It looks interesting, that's for sure. Very simplistic design. Looks nice. Oh yeah, now that's a sword. That's something I've been waiting for. That's more of just like a cold steel one. That's probably the coloration I would use. So just some more cutlasses, mostly for those outlaw rogues out there. Okay, so we go to daggers next. I've never been a big fan of daggers. Ooh, that one has some nice shadow effects going to it. Doesn't look like the shadow effect is changed at all. This is like a lesser Zalatath, the priest artifact. Oh, that's going to get used in some transmog, I can see it. I mean, yeah, I could see this being a dagger, but it looks more like an axe to me. Call me picky. I'm trying to remember. What the miniature cutlass is called. I can't remember. It might just be called a cutlass, but I'm pretty sure it's not. The cutlass. Oh yeah, there's no way that is a dagger. That's a fist weapon. Very fancy cutlass there. Yeah, that's a fist weapon. But still, that is a good looking fist weapon. We don't get very many good looking fist weapons, sadly. Interesting colorations there. So fist weapons? Ooh. Fist weapons are getting a lot of love this expansion. That functionality must be broken. I can't drag my character up at all. Kind of bland. Maybe some people will use this, but I personally wouldn't. Doesn't look very interesting to me. And sadly, that seems to be it for fist weapons. So let's go to two-handed axes. Ooh, we're starting to get some big axes back. Just moving around in my chair. These are obviously placeholder. I'm really on the fence about this model. I really like how it looks, but with all the cracks and everything in the bone blade, it really just ruins my interest in it. Okay, so the green one has some more accentuated decal on the blade. Same with the gold one. Oh no, the purple one just has less. Okay. Let's go to two-handed swords. Ooh, that is a nice one. I think this black one's going to be the most popular. Yeah, see, it's in two-handed swords now. That's definitely a two-handed sword, I figured. And that is a nice-looking sword. Very basic, but that's just sweet-looking. People will definitely use this for transmog. And a lot of people say, oh, it looks like a quest green. This is a quest green. Well, technically it's a rare, but this is what a quest green looks like. Quest greens are not bad. I actually tend to find that quest greens are the best looking stuff. And nice for getting another sight. I really like this model. Holy crap, I really want to use this model for transmog now. I think that's the model I would use. I'm not a huge fan of it. Is the tentacle move or no? I thought I saw it move. Nope. Okay. I mean, I'm not a huge fan of the staff. I'm not going to say it looks bad. Definitely has some accentuation to it. It's very basic other than the lightning. I'm not sure I would use this. Of course, that's gotta be placeholder. And that drops from a raid. Ooh, that does look nice. I'm not a huge fan of this one where it's like rusted over metal. I'm guessing this will be the mythic version. That's pretty cool. I'm guessing this is all stuff from that like cultist area in the Alliance Zone. Ooh, trolls are gonna have a field day with all the new transmog they get. I really like how they made an anchor out of a staff. It's just very cool to me. This looks like a kind of like a high priest staff for the Zandalari. Go to pole arms. Ooh, we got a nice little axe pole arm here. This is something I think people will definitely use. Of course, I don't think we have a green version. Maybe they made a recolor out of an old model. Ooh, a double-bladed polearm? That is cool. I don't think we have one of those. I really want to use this for transmog now. Holy crap. I mean, it's very basic. I'd say it looks worse than the Axe one up here, but people have their preferences. Okay, so this is a really long pole arm, kind of like something a monk would use, like a long staff. I'm very glad to see that the pole arms are getting a lot of love. Oh, that's just the marksmanship bow. And let's see. I really like how that looks. I might use that one for transmog. I don't know yet. It was cool. So, I really like the pull animation on the Zandalari bows. That pull animation just looks satisfying to me. I haven't gotten to play with it yet because I mess with my bars and now this is the second video I'm making. But I have to say, it looks pretty cool. Okay, it's official, we're getting a flamethrower. Now if only it was a legit flamethrower. This is the model I think everyone would use. This is a raid boss item? I mean, it looks nice, but it doesn't really look that interesting to me. Ooh, that looks pretty good. And it looks like that's it for guns. And any love for crossbows? We get one new crossbow, and it honestly looks hideous to me. So let's look at, oh, that's right, I can't look at shields as a hunter. Well, that sucks. But the thing I'm most interested in is if you go back to this, you can see that this is going to be the shoulder for the armor set in, I believe, the first raid. I believe Uldir is going to be the first raid. Honestly, that looks sick. I'm very happy to see that we're getting some good male armor out of raids again. Like, Shaman tends to get all the cool stuff, like this looks awesome, but Hunter tends not to. And I am pretty much convinced this is Hunter, because I don't see why Shaman would wear a giant jawbone on their shoulder. That's more of a hunter thing. Although I just find it funny that we wear mail, but a lot of our best looking armor does not look like mail armor in the slightest. That's some cool looking shoulders. Let's look at the troll armor set. That would be this, I think. Yeah, that's the coloring for that one. Then that would be the blue one. So this is the questing armor set for Battle for Azeroth. It looks pretty good in my opinion. I would definitely use the shoulders and the belt. The boots open up a ton of options if you're going by the use no more than two or three pieces from a set rule, which I like to do because I like to make unique transmogs. I'm not sure if I would use that helmet for anything. It looks interesting, but it looks like it would be very hard to get anything to match with it. Oh, and I did skip over the cloaks, because honestly, I hate cloaks. For those of you who like cloaks, here's a quick preview of them. Like, the only cloak I have ever liked was the legendary cloak from Mists of Pandaria. From Antorus. I actually kind of like this cloak, but still, I just don't like the physics they have on cloaks. And that's all the gear I can show you on the Hunter. Right now, I'm not planning on playing another class unless I get satisfied with the Hunter testing I'm doing. Because I've been playing Hunter ever since I've been playing Hunter since Wrath of the Lich King. I did raid for a little bit in Dragon Soul as a Death Knight, but otherwise it's always been my Hunter as my main. So, if I'm happy with where Hunters are, I'll probably test out other classes too, but I would expect mostly Hunter changes and such from me. So, that's what the transmog looks like for a lot of what you can... Man, I cannot talk right now. That's what a lot of the transmog looks like upcoming in Battle for Azeroth.